Hello CS executive friends, I am Tejpal Shet, practicing company secretary, author and academician. In this video, I am going to discuss the paper of a company law, December 2016. I am having the paper in my hand and it will be a better if you are also having a paper available to you so that you can refer some of the question while I am discussing the answer of it. Paper na to lengthy tha na short tha, it was appropriate in my opinion so the student can complete it within a specified time of 3 hours. There were two questions, question number 2 and question number 3, which were having the alternative available. 2A for a question number 2, 3 capital A for a question number 3. Apart from that, no alternatives, no option was available. Question number 1 was on the theoretical part, testing the basic understanding of the concept of a Companies Act. But if you refer the entire paper, definitely you will tell that sir, it is a practical question based question paper. And now onwards, what I understand that institute is emphasizing the practical based questions. Yani aage bhi aapko isi tarah se questions aur question paper dekhne ko mil sakta hai, kyunki institute ne apna jo nazariya hai paper nikalne ka, paper check karne ka, jo evaluation pattern bhi bol sakte hai, wo badal diya hai. Pehle questions zyadatar repeat hote the, theoretical form mein question puche jaate the, ab aisa nahi hai. Let us discuss the question number 1. Comment on the following. Each question or sub question was for 5 marks. Question number 1A. A director insists that he is not of a dissent be recorded in the minute of the board meeting which he attended and did not agree to the sum of the point of the agenda. Pehla question tricky or corner kiya hua hai. Those who have not gone through the each and every detail of a Companies Act, they found themselves into the strange situation. Ya kahan se question aaya? Maine bahut sare student ko aisa bhi kehte hue suna hai ki it is the question out of the syllabus. Kyunki is tarah ka question unhone kahin pehle padha nahi hai. But obvious, most of the student refer the past several years question paper जो आप लोग बोलते हो scanner वगैरह. अब scanner आपको scan करना पड़ेगा. Scanner scan करने के बाद आपको पता चलेगा कि what is the coverage and what are left and you will find new questions in a question paper. So really the scanner is required to be scanned in my opinion. Remember my dear friend, the question has been asked from the secretary's standard 1 and as per the secretary's standard 1 which is now compulsory, aapko ye pata hoga ki SS1, secretary's standard 1 and secretary's standard 2 jo general meeting ke liye hai, dono aap compulsory hai under the Companies Act. According to the secretary's standard 1, if the any director want his dissent should be recorded and answer therefore should be statement is correct. Even though he is disagree on a some point of agenda, the minute should have a reference of that as a secretary standard kehta hai and therefore it has to be recorded. Let us move to the question number 1B. A member of a company has a statutory right to appoint a proxy for a general meeting. Similarly, a director can also appoint his proxy for attending the meeting of a board. Remember, yahan pe do sentences hai. One sentence is a correct, while on the other hand, the another or second sentence is not a correct. The student should write first, the statement is or the statements are partly correct or partly incorrect. Remember, the member can appoint the proxy, but the director cannot appoint the proxy for a board meeting. And in the case of the board meeting, director himself has to attend the board meeting, right? So in my opinion, 1B was a very easy question. Let us move to the question number 1C. Issue of an unsecured debenture by a company to another company, where the debentures have an option for a compulsory conversion. Students should focus on some of the words. Compulsory conversion, you underline, into the equity shares within the 7 years cannot be termed as a deposit. So, यहाँ पे जो doubt या जो confusion है student के लिए वो ये है कि sir ये deposit का question है या debenture का question है. Remember my dear friend, it is a question of a deposit. And if you refer the amended rules for a deposit, company's deposit rules amended, so then you will be able to answer it correctly. It says that if the debenture is secured by the first charge on the asset which is covered under Schedule 3, and if it is not an intangible asset, where the redemption, compulsory redemption or compulsory conversion is taking place within a period of 10 years, it will not be regarded as a deposit. Aisa koi provision hai, right? Here it is for 7 years. So you may understand the answer. But most of the student wrote the incorrect answer in the exam. Question number 1D. A meeting of the board of directors was scheduled to take place at the factory premises of a company and not at the registered office. At the scheduled date and time, the required quorum was not present. The chairman of the meeting announced that the meeting is dissolved. Statement galat hai. Sab log jante hai ki board meeting if could not be proceeded due to the want of a quorum, then it will be adjourned to the same day, same time, same place in a next week, which is not a national holiday, right? अब बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट उन्होंने लिखा है पब्लिक हॉलीडे, तो मेरे हिसाब से पब्लिक हॉलीडे और नेशनल हॉलीडे में फर्क बनता है. एंड नाउअडेज द कंपनीज एक्ट हैज यूज्ड द वर्ड नेशनल हॉलीडे, राइट. हाउएवर द आर्टिकल मे प्रोवाइड अदरवाइज, ये भी लिखना चाहिए बिकॉज द वेटेज ऑफ द क्वेश्चन इज ऑफ 5 मार्क्स. तो आपने ये पॉइंट नहीं लिखा, इफ द आर्टिकल प्रोवाइड अदरवाइज इट इज अलाउड और कैन बी अरेंज इन अ डिफरेंट मैनर, मेरे हिसाब से आपका 1 मार्क कट हो सकता है, 1 मार्क कम मिल सकता है. आपको यहां ये भी समझना जरूरी है कि कैसे मार्क मिलेंगे, क्या लिखना है और कैसे लिखना है. बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट्स चार्ट मेथड से पढ़ते हैं और चार्ट मेथड से पढ़ने से वो ऐसा सोचते हैं कि मुझे सब याद रह गया है. चार्ट मेथड से आपका मेमोरी ही रहेगा, इट हेल्प यू इन अ मेमोरी, बट इट विल नॉट हेल्प यू इन क्लियरिंग द कॉन्सेप्ट, राइट. सो यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू रीड लाइन बाय लाइन. कोई भी कानून पढ़ते हो, चाहे वो कंपनीज एक्ट हो या दूसरा एक्ट, if you want to be the master, you will have to read line by line, you will have to understand the meaning of the each word. Otherwise, in a chart, you will lost somewhere when the tricky question is asked. Question number 2. Question number 2 is on the difference or distinguish. If you are referring the past paper on a continuous basis, aapne observe kiya hoga, कि एक क्वेश्चन पूरा एक क्वेश्चन इंस्टीट्यूट ने डिस्टिंग्विश या डिफरेंस पे रखा हुआ है. इट इज अ गुड एज वेल एज बैड. अ गुड फॉर दोज हु आर अ कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियर एंड बैड फॉर दोज हु आर फॉलोइंग द रॉट मेथड. अब मैं आपको एक छोटा सा एग्जाम्पल देके समझाता हूं बिफोर डिस्कसिंग क्वेश्चन नंबर टू कि कैसे गुड या बैड हो सकता है. बिकॉज आई हैव सीन सो मेनी फैकल्टी एंड स्टूडेंट ऐसा कहते हुए फॉलो करते हुए कि ये 15 या 20 डिफरेंस या डिस्टिंग्विश का लिस्ट है, यदि तुमने इतना कर लिया तो यू विल गेट द कंप्लीट मार्क, यू कैन एनकैश द मार्क एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. कि आपको लगता है कि कोई भी कॉन्सेप्ट जो है वो इंस्टीट्यूट या पेपर सेटर हर बार रिपीट करेगा? नहीं, इट इज नॉट नेसेसरी. लेट अस हैव अ लुक और लेट अस हैव एन एग्जांपल. सी फॉर एग्जांपल प्रोस्पेक्टस इज अ टॉपिक. अब यहां पे बहुत सारे डिफरेंस पूछ सकते हैं, जैसे कि प्रोस्पेक्टस एंड द सेल्फ प्रोस्पेक्टस. Prospectus and the information memorandum. Prospectus and red herring prospectus. A prospectus and share certificate. ये आपको कहीं भी कोई भी बुक में देखने को नहीं मिलेगा. Prospectus versus share certificate. आपने देखा होगा शेयर सर्टिफिकेट वर्सेस स्टॉक सर्टिफिकेट, शेयर्स वर्सेस स्टॉक, प्रेफरेंस शेयर्स वर्सेस इक्विटी शेयर्स. तो कोई भी तरीके का कॉन्सेप्ट लेके आपको डिफरेंस पूछ सकते हैं, इसलिए डू नॉट फॉलो द रॉट मेथड, फॉलो द कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियरिटी विच विल हेल्प यू इन एनी काइंड ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन एंड इन एनी कैटेगरी ऑफ द पेपर. भले ही चाहे कितना डिफिकल्ट पेपर हो, अगर आपके पास कॉन्सेप्ट क्लियरिटी है तो आप डेफिनेटली लिख सकते हो. आपको आगे पूछा प्रोस्पेक्टस एंड डीम्ड प्रोस्पेक्टस. नाउ यू विल नॉट फाइंड ऑल द डिफरेंस इन वन बुक और इफ यू रेफर ऑल द बुक्स. आगे मैं बढ़ सकता हूं, आई कैन हैव अ डिफरेंट कैटेगरी. Same, I am now taking the difference of a self prospectus versus information memorandum. Self prospectus versus abridged prospectus. Self prospectus versus red herring prospectus. Self prospectus versus deemed prospectus. Now this will continue, my dear friends, and I can take the red herring prospectus and have another combination. By this method, one can have almost the 50 difference just in one chapter, and I can make it 100. With my expertise, I can make it 100. Right? Now, do you think that can you pass the exam with the flying colors, with the good marks? Just by following the rote method, नहीं. यानी जो ऐसा कहता है आपका दोस्त कि ये 10 का लिस्ट है, ये करने से तुम्हें मार्क मिल जाएंगे, उसका मतलब समझिए कि वो रोट मेथड वाला है. राइट, लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2A. डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन द AGM एंड द EGM. Annual General Meeting and the Extraordinary General Meeting. Everyone understand about the AGM. Holding the one AGM once in a year is a compulsory. Holding the EGM is not a compulsory. Company may convey the more than one EGM in a year. AGM is for the purpose of four routine businesses. आपको पता है, EGM is for the purpose of discussing some extraordinary matter. तो ये डिफरेंस है, आप पढ़ के समझ सकते हो. मुझे नहीं लगता है कि मुझे ज्यादा यहां डिस्कस करना चाहिए ये क्वेश्चन के बारे में. सो आई एम मूविंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन. और नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन जो मैं कह रहा था थोड़े समय पहले, उसका क्लासिक एग्जांपल है. वेयर द इंस्टीट्यूट हैज आस्क्ड अबाउट द डिस्टिंग्विश between the associate company and subsidiary company. देखो associate company और subsidiary company का फर्क पूछा गया है. It is for a 4 marks. बहुत सारे student पूछते हैं कि sir, it is for a 4 marks. How much? Up to what length? We should write. कितना लिखे सर? आधा पेज लिखे, पूरा पेज लिखे, 3 point लिखे, इतना लिखे, उतना लिखे. बहुत सिंपल मेरा आंसर है कि जो पॉइंट है वो आपको लिखने हैं. बिकॉज इन अ प्रोफेशनल एग्जाम द क्वांटिटी इज अ इमटेरियल, क्वालिटी इज अ नीडेड. तो एसोसिएट कंपनी और सब्सिडरी कंपनी जिसमें कंपनी का कंट्रोल होता है, राइट, दोनों की डेफिनेशन लिखे. यू मे ऑल्सो राइट डाउन द एग्जाम्पल, यू मे ऑल्सो राइट डाउन द सेक्शन. एंड मूविंग द नेक्स्ट पॉइंट is a question number 2C. Distinguish between the mortgage and the charge. ये भी काफी अच्छा है. Chapter number 10 से है, जो कि charge registration के बारे में है. Charge is defined under the Companies Act. The mortgage is not separately defined under the Companies Act. However, if you look into the Transfer of Property Act 1882, the mortgage is defined there. However, if you refer the definition of a charge under the Companies Act, the mortgage is included in the charge. Right? हालांकि थोड़ा बहुत फर्क है, तो ये हमें ध्यान में रखना है. चार्ज के लिए सारे प्रोविजन दिए हैं, वही प्रोविजन अगर कंपनी है तो मॉर्गेज को भी लागू होंगे. क्वेश्चन नंबर 2D, डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स एंड ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ शेयर्स. काफी पुराना जाना माना हुआ और रिपीटेड क्वेश्चन. बच्चे, आई एम श्योर कि बच्चे सब देख के खुश हो गए होंगे कि ऐसा कुछ क्वेश्चन आ गया जो हम कंट्रोल सी कंट्रोल बी कर सके. ट्रांसफर इज अ वॉलंटरी एक्ट. ट्रांसमिशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस बाय द प्रोसेस ऑफ द एक्ट, लॉ, यूजुअली ऑन अ डेथ. आप एग्जाम्पल लिख सकते हो, आप फॉर्म लिख सकते हो, आप प्रोसेस का डिफरेंस लिख सकते हो. मेरे हिसाब से ट्रांसफर ऑफ शेयर्स और ट्रांसमिशन ऑफ शेयर्स में आपके पास काफी मटेरियल है, आप लिख सकते हो. यहां पे क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 कंप्लीट हुआ. नाउ लेट अस रिव्यू द क्वेश्चन नंबर 2 कैपिटल ए, व्हिच इज अ अल्टरनेटिव ऑफ अ क्वेश्चन नंबर 2. 2A1, इट इज अ प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन, not a new practical question. It has been found that Mrs. Sweta, a director of a company, has drawn the remuneration in excess of the prescribed limit. The chief financial officer of a company has sought your advice in the matter. As a company secretary, advise the CFO the course of action that may be taken in this regard. Remember, the director cannot be paid or director cannot receive the excess remuneration then what has been prescribed by the limit under the act, or when the permission is given by the central government within the prescribed of the central government. Agar kisi director ko limit se zyada ya central government ne jo limit rakha hua hai usse zyada payment kiya gaya hai, to then he is required to or she is required to keep it under the trust, right? So here the CFO may be given the advice not to pay the any further amount for the same year because it is already in excess. Point number 2, she will be asked to refund or return the money. Until the time she returned the money, it will be considered as held in a trust by her, right? If the company wants to pay the excess remuneration, company will have to get the permission of the central government. So these are the action, or these are the options or the steps to be suggested as a secretary to the CFO of a company. Question number 2A2. It is again the practical question, a lollipop question, yani ekdam easy question. There are 7 shareholders in a private limited company having a registered office in Chennai. 6 shareholders are French nationals and belong to the same family holding an aggregate of a 95% of voting power. These shareholders are unable to come down to the Chennai and wish to hold the company's general meeting in a Paris. Advise whether the meeting can be held in a Paris. Mere hisab se, mere experience se, I am sure that most of the student must have written no, but it is not a complete answer. My dear friend, usually or a general rule is that if you refer to section 96 of the Companies Act 2013, it says that the AGM of a company should be held within a same limit town or place where the registrar office of the company is situated. But if you refer the section 96 in a nutshell, it further provides that in the case of the AGM, if the application is made, the central government may exempt the any company from the provision. So it means if this private company would like to convey the AGM out of India, then it is possible only with the permission of the central government. Almost student ne ye nahi likha hoga, isliye unko aadhe mark milenge. Because what you have stated is the first provision. Now, according to the provision or exception or a benefit granted by the central government, the alternative possibility also arises. You are required to state that alternative possibility. Aage badhta hoon main. Question number 3. 2A ka 3. Again, it is a practical question from the promoter chapter. Kamal, the promoter of a Desire Limited, has incurred rupees 1 lakh for a formation of a company. Yani usne apne pocket mein se kharcha kiya hai. The company refused to pay all the expenses so incurred by the Kamal since the company does not have any provision in the article of a company for such a payment. Advise the Kamal regarding the remedy available to him for his claim. Remember, dear friends, company ka paper hai, isliye aap sirf Companies Act 2013 ke provision dhyan mein loge. Usually, under the Industrial Labour General Group, jo dusre group mein aata hai, students are learning about the Specific Relief Act 1963. Hame yahan pe wo combine nahi karna hai. And according to the provision of the Companies Act 2013, promoter can reimburse or can recover the incorporation expenses from the company in a following two situations. Number one, if there is a valid contract between the company and the promoter, aur wo hoga company ke incorporation ke baad. Number two, if the article of a company authorize the board of director to do so. Practical life mein maine aisa dekha hai ki most of the company's article provide about the reimbursement of the preliminary expenses incurred by the promoter in starting the company. Agar ye dono ki dono condition absent hai, then the Kamal here, the promoter, cannot reimburse the expenses from the company. Number 4, question number 2A, sub question 4. Again, it is a practical question, and it is a practical question based upon the threshold limit. Dhyan rakhiye, my dear friends, aapko ek ya do question chote chote aise dekhne ko milenge paper mein, which is purely based upon the threshold limit. Aur Companies Act mein alag alag jagah pe aapko bahut sari threshold hai, jaise ki CSR ke liye threshold alag hai, nomination committee ke liye alag hai, audit committee ke liye alag hai, woman director ke liye alag hai, independent director ke liye alag hai. So the question here is on the woman director. Divan Industry Private Limited has a turnover of 350 crore. During the financial year 14-15, the bankers of the company have advised the company to compulsorily appoint a woman director in the company as required under the Companies Act 2013. Referring to the provision of the Act, examine the validity of the banker's advice. What would be your answer in the case the company in a question is a public company? Right? Remember, my dear friend, the threshold limit for a woman director is given under the rule number 3 of the company's appointment of a director and qualification of a director's rules. And it says listed company, sare listed company ko woman director lagu hote hai. Turnover ke liye jo threshold hai, that is a 300 crore rupees, right? Yahan pe jo turnover diya hai question mein, it is a 350 crore, but the company is a private company jisko ye lagu nahi hai. And therefore, the first paragraph of our answer should be that it is not applicable to the Divine Industries Private Limited. लेकिन कहीं question के end में आपको ये भी पूछा गया है कि whether your answer would be a different if it is a public company. Of course, if it would be the public company, and as and when it crosses the 300 crore of a turnover, they are supposed to appoint the woman director. Right? So question number 2, capital A, is a over. Let us discuss the question number 3. Question number 3 is having the option 3, capital A. As of now, I am discussing the question number 3A, number A, small A. Peculiar Limited, an unlisted company, did not prepare its financial statement for the year ended 31st March 2016 in a conformity with some of the mandatory accounting standard. देखिए student कैसी गलती करते हैं, student ऐसा ही समझ लेते हैं कि company ने accounting standard के student ऐसा ही समझ लेते हैं कि company ने financial statement नहीं बनाया है. While the language is very clear, it indicates that the financial statement is prepared but not as per the accounting standard. With reference to the provision of a Companies Act 2013, state the responsibilities of the directors and the auditor of the company in this regard. Question is of 4 marks. Practical question hai. Chapter number 21, accounts mein, accounts audit mein. Remember, my dear friend, when the financial statements are not prepared as per the mandatory accounting standards, auditor as well as the directors of the company both are having a certain responsibility. So, pehle samajhte hain ki auditor ki zimmedari kya hogi. So, auditor is required to qualify his audit report. Yani auditor apne audit report mein likhega ki so and so accounting standards are not complied with. The reason thereof and its effect on the entire result or a financial preparation. Once the auditor provides this kind of a qualification in his audit report, the director is required to reply the qualification into his director's report. And if the auditor has not included this qualification or any reference about the non-compliances, then he may be liable for the purpose of non-compliance or non-fulfillment of a duty of an auditor. He can be charged for the negligency or a professional misconduct. On the other hand, the directors can also be held responsible if the same kind of things are not followed by the directors. Question number 3A, sorry, question number 3B. A 3-year-old producer company wants to donate a sum amount. Advise the company as to how and for what purposes such a donation can be made. What are the monetary restrictions in this regard? In this context, you are also informed that the net profit of the producer company for the last accounting year was a 12 lakh rupees. Bahut easy question hai. Chapter number 28 producer company se hai. Jab hum producer company ki baat karte hai, to utna hame pata hona chahiye ki producer company ke liye old companies act, yani companies act 1956 applicable hai. Ye bahut hi corner kiya hua point hai. Yani question is designed from the corner point. usually the students are aware, but sometimes they are not able to remember the percentage per memory. और यहाँ पे मैं आपका ध्यान ऐसी जगह पे draw करना चाहता हूँ जो आप गलती करते हो, because a number of students I come across, they are learning by way of some design or decorative things. बहुत सारे स्टूडेंट ऐसे होते हैं जो वीडियो लेक्चर्स या ऐसे लेक्चर के जरिए सीखते हैं, लर्न करते हैं, जिसमें कंटेंट कॉन्सेप्ट कम होते हैं और एनिमेशन ज्यादा होता है. जैसे कि प्रोड्यूसर कंपनी का कोई चैप्टर शुरू हुआ तो प्रोड्यूसर कंपनी है उसको दिखाया जाएगा, पेड़ पौधे बन रहे हैं, पेड़ पौधे एग्रीकल्चर एक्टिविटी, तो वो विजुअलाइजेशन आपको समझने में मदद करेगा, पूरा का पूरा कॉन्सेप्ट क्लैरिटी नहीं देगा. तो एनिमेशन जो है वो आपको एक एंटरटेनमेंट फैक्टर देता है, आपको एक्सप्लेनेशन नहीं देता है. ना तो आपका लॉजिक बढ़ेगा या समझ में आएगा ज्यादा, आप एनिमेशन देख के यू मे फील हैप्पी, यू मे फील गुड, बट दिस फीलिंग गुड फैक्टर इज फॉर अ टाइम बीइंग एंड इन माय ओपिनियन इट इज नॉट अ मोर देन 6 months, क्योंकि रिजल्ट आएगा तो आपको पता चलेगा कि एनिमेशन का कोई इफेक्ट नहीं है. यहां पे नेट प्रॉफिट जो है उसका 3% प्रोड्यूसर कंपनी के नॉट एट एंड दैट इज अ प्रोविजन. 3% आप जानते हो हाउ टू कैलकुलेट इट, सो आई एम नॉट राइटिंग, आई एम नॉट शोइंग इट टू यू. राइट, मूविंग द नेक्स्ट सब क्वेश्चन 3C, इट इज अगेन अ प्रैक्टिकल क्वेश्चन. बहुत टाइम पहले एक बार सीएस में पूछा गया है, एक दो बार ऐसे क्वेश्चन पूछे गए हैं, यानी ये क्वेश्चन भी ऐसा कोई ट्रिकी या टिपिकल नहीं है. एट द जनरल मीटिंग ऑफ अ सोया लिमिटेड अ मैटर वाज टू बी ट्रांजैक्टेड बाय पासिंग अ स्पेशल रेजोल्यूशन. आउट ऑफ 40 मेंबर्स प्रेजेंट, 20 वोटेड इन फेवर ऑफ अ रेजोल्यूशन, 5 वोटेड अगेंस्ट इट एंड 5 वोट्स वर फाउंड इनवैलिड. The remaining 10 members abstained from voting. The chairman of the meeting declared the resolution as a pass, referring the provision of a Companies Act 2013. Examine the validity of the chairman's declaration. Special resolution, student jante hai ki 3/4 of the majority, yani 75% of majority, lekin jaise ki maine aapko kaha ki if you are learning through the chart, you remember the 75%. But the chart is written in a concise and compact form. यानी आपका उस पर ध्यान नहीं गया होगा कि 75% of what? So 75% of the total vote casted, right? And therefore the 10 members who remain abstained from voting are not counted. यानी गिनती है वो 30 में से होगी. So if it is a 3/4 of the 30, the special resolution is deemed to be passed, otherwise not. Moving the question number 3, small d, right? Again, it is a practical question, and in my opinion, it is one of the good question the examiner or paper setter has set out in this paper. Really, so far, you know, we have come across a number of questions, almost 10 or 12. But this question number 3D, I really admire, I really appraise the examiner or paper sitter for this question. Suresh, a member of Ruchi Limited, wants to inspect the register of deposits maintained by the company as required by the provision of the Companies Act 2013. The company refused to provide the register for inspection without assigning the reason. यहां पे स्टूडेंट ज्यादा फोकस करेंगे विदाउट असाइनिंग द रीजन. रेफरिंग टू द प्रोविजन ऑफ द एक्ट, एग्जामिन द वैलिडिटी ऑफ द कंपनीज रिफ्यूजल. व्हाट शैल बी योर आंसर इफ द सेम रजिस्टर इज डिमांडेड बाय द ऑडिटर ऑफ द कंपनी फॉर इंस्पेक्शन एंड फॉर देयर ऑडिट. थ्रू आउट द कंपनीज एक्ट, थ्रू आउट द कंपनीज एक्ट एंड इन अ नंबर ऑफ बुक्स, यू विल नॉट फाइंड whether the register of the deposit are open for an inspection to the members. Remember, the answer is that this register of a deposits are not open for an inspection to the members. However, the registers of a deposits are open for inspection to the auditor, statutory auditor, only for the purpose of executing or performing his duty, right? And therefore, if the management refused to provide the inspection to the member, the management is justified. But if the management refused to provide the inspection to the auditor, it is not justified. The question number 3 is complete. Now let us examine the question number 3, capital A, which is the alternative to the question number 3. Again, the question number 3, capital A, consists the lot of practical questions. Number A, yani para question, it is the question from the LLP. Bahut sare faculty at the last moment provide the list of the important topic. और उसमें से मैंने देखा हुआ है कि वो LLP पे ज़्यादा फोकस नहीं करते हैं. यहाँ पे LLP का क्वेश्चन पूछा गया है. बच्चों का नसीब अच्छा होगा. सो दे हैव गॉट द ऑल्टरनेटिव और ऑप्शन. नोवेल LLP, अ ट्रेडमार्क एंड पेटेंट अटॉर्नी, हैज और हैव बीन सॉरी सक्सेसफुली रनिंग देयर बिजनेस फॉर द लास्ट 5 years. They have fixed asset in the form of intangible, that is a software worth of rupees 75 lakhs in their balance sheet. Advice as to whether their accounts are to be audited. If you will find or try to find out the answer from the material which is ordinary in category, जिसको मैं कहता हूँ म्यूजिकल नोट्स, जो न्यू नोट्स ऐसे होते हैं जिसमें से संगीत बजता रहता है, यानी एक लाइन दो लाइन में पूरा का पूरा आंसर खत्म. LLP देखिए तो दो पेज में LLP खत्म. तो वहाँ पे लायबिलिटी लिमिटेड है और आपकी लायबिलिटी अनलिमिटेड है. इट इज नॉट द क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द एक्ट, इट इज अ क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम द रूल्स. And if you refer the rule number 24 of the LLP rules 2009, you may have a clue about the answer. And it says that in the last financial year, that means in a preceding financial year, if the LLP is having a turnover of more than 40 lakh rupees or a contribution of more than 25 lakhs, then the accounts are of the LLP are required to be audited. यहाँ पे हमें balance sheet दी नहीं है. हाँ, हालांकि यहाँ पे जरूर ऐसा कहा है कि दे आर हैविंग अ फिक्स्ड एसेट और सॉफ्टवेयर इनटेंजिबल एसेट ऑफ 75 लाख रुपीस, बट इट इज अ सिली टू अंडरस्टैंड और एज्यूम दैट द 75 लाख शुड ऑलवेज बी ब्रॉट बाय द LLP पार्टनर्स फ्रॉम देयर पॉकेट, राइट? दे मे हैव वांट इट फ्रॉम द लोन और अ बोरोइंग और बाय अदर मीन. सो इन माई ओपिनियन द ऑडिट ऑफ दिस LLP इज नॉट रिक्वायर्ड टू बी डन. Moving to question number B, 3, capital A, दूसरा यानी B यहाँ पे. Again, it is a good question and it is a question which is really targeting the provision of a Companies Act 2013. Out of the 9 directors in a rooftop limited, 5 are the Indian nationals, 3 are the foreign resident, and 1 is a person of an Indian origin. The articles of a company stipulate that the quorum for a board meeting shall be the 5 directors, of which at least 1 director shall be the foreign national or a foreign resident. Referring to provision of the Companies Act, examine the validity of the above provision in the article. Question is with regard to the quorum in a reference of the board meeting, section 174 of the Companies Act 2013. Contain and suggest that the quorum for a board meeting shall be the 1/3 of a total number of a director or a 2 director, whichever is a higher, right? Now, in relation with the section 174, if you refer somewhere in the provision of chapter of article, it has been clarified that the article of a company may contain the stricter provision. And here, if the article of a company provide the higher quorum, then what is specified under the act, nothing wrong in it. बहुत सारे students ने लिखा है कि ये गलत है. This kind of a provision article cannot contain. There is nothing wrong in it. And if the article provide that this should be the number present at the meeting, out of which one should be the director present from the particular category, nothing wrong in it. It is not violating any of the concept of the Companies Act. So article is valid. Moving the question 3, capital A, C. The board of directors of KM Limited proposes to transfer the 11.33% of the net profit of the company for a financial year 2015-16 to the General Reserve. Examining the provision of the Companies Act 2013, advise the board whether it can go ahead with the proposal or not. Remember, company do not have any obligation to transfer the any specified percentage of the net profit to the General Reserve. So company can transfer the any amount. No doubt the company is required to follow the certain procedure, like they will have to pass a resolution for transferring this amount from a non-net profit to the General Reserve. So one should write about the procedure or the obligation on the part of a board of directors. Next question, D. Priya, a nominee director on the board of Aroma Limited, a listed company, informed the board of directors during the board meeting that the next annual report of the company shall contain a management discussion and analysis report. You, being the company secretary, have been asked by the board to prepare a said report. State the matter you would like to include in the report. Remember, the board report provision already contain what are the points, what are the matters to be included under the management discussion and analysis report. In my opinion, it is a theoretical question and you can deal with it very easily if you have gone through this kind of a theory in a perfect manner. Otherwise not. Here, the question number 3A completes. Question number 4, small a, it is a question on drafting of a notice. Generally, it has been said that drafting aspect is not covered at the executive level. लेकिन पिछले दो question papers में लगातार देख रहा हूँ कि drafting के कुछ ना कुछ एक question को जरूर पूछ लेते हैं. तो student should prepare for drafting. Ria Technologies Limited was incorporated 10 years back. The board of directors now wants to change the name to Ria System Limited. Draft notice and the explanatory statement for calling the EGM. Right, assume the relevant data. Now, very interesting point here is that this question is only for 4 marks. And looking to the content or a length, आप जो भी notice लिखोगे, उसमें एक resolution होगा proposed. और उसका एक्सप्लेनेटरी स्टेटमेंट भी होगा क्योंकि ईजीएम है और बिजनेस का नेचर ऐसा है. सो लुकिंग टू द लेंथ द मार्क्स आर लेस, लेकिन उसका मतलब ऐसा नहीं है कि आप कुछ भी उसके साथ छेड़खानी करो. यू आर रिक्वायर्ड टू राइट इन अ कंप्लीट मैनर. हालांकि यहाँ पे मैं पूरा अभी ड्राफ्ट नहीं करूँगा. यू कैन रेफर इट एनीवेयर फ्रॉम एनीवेयर और फ्रॉम माई बुक ड्राफ्ट नोटिस एंड द एक्सपेक्टेड स्टेटमेंट. My book will be available very soon, a latest. Already the first edition is in the market. Question number 4B. The Barkha Limited has 4 directors on its board. A board meeting was convened which was attended by only 2 directors, where the Rekha was appointed as an additional director. Rekha is related to both the directors. Referring to the provision of the Companies Act 2013, examine the validity of the appointment. यहाँ पे student focus करेंगे quorum पे. 4 director हैं, 1/3 or 2, whichever is higher. So 2 will be the higher, 2 directors present. So student will consider that the quorum is present, the resolution is valid, and appointment is valid. But if you refer to the section 184, read along with section 188, you will find that In the case of public company, public limited company, here refer the Barkha Limited, public limited company, the interested director cannot participate at the board meeting. यहाँ पे क्लियरली कहा गया है कि रेखा इज रिलेटेड विद बोथ द डायरेक्टर्स, यानी बोथ द डायरेक्टर्स प्रेजेंट एट द मीटिंग, राइट? एंड देयरफॉर द मीटिंग कैन नॉट बी सीन टू बी हेल्ड इन अ वैलिड मैनर. अपॉइंटमेंट इज ऑल्सो नॉट अ वैलिड इन माई ओपिनियन. आगे बढ़ते हैं क्वेश्चन नंबर 4C. राइज लिमिटेड अ कंपनी विद अ डाइवर्सिफाइड इंटरेस्ट हैज कॉन्स्टिट्यूटेड इन्वेस्टर एजुकेशन प्रोटेक्शन फंड, जिसको शॉर्ट में कहा जाता है IEPF. As required under the provision of a Companies Act 2013, ध्यान रहे कि जो पुराने जो प्रोविजन थे सेक्शन 205 ABC, which were related with the IEPF under the Companies Act 1956, has now or have now replaced with the section 124 and 125 of the Companies Act 2013. यानी आपको नए प्रोविजन ध्यान में रखने हैं एज फार एज इन्वेस्टर एजुकेशन प्रोटेक्शन फंड के प्रोविजन की हम बात करते हैं. द कंपनी हैज सो फार नॉट डिपॉजिटेड एनी अमाउंट टू द फंड. द प्रेसिडेंट फाइनेंस हैज आस्क्ड यू द कंपनी सेक्रेटरी टू सबमिट अ नोट ऑन अमाउंट्स पेएबल टू द क्रेडिट ऑफ द फंड एंड द पीरियड विद इन विच द अमाउंट शैल बी पेड. प्रिपेयर द सेम नोट. यानी क्वेश्चन थ्योरेटिकल है, आपको IEPF में कौन कौन सी अमाउंट कब ट्रांसफर करनी है, कौन सा फॉर्म भरना है वो लिखना होगा. यू मे रिफर द पैराग्राफ नंबर 13 ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 22 ऑफ माय बुक. आगे बढ़ते हैं क्वेश्चन नंबर 5. अब यहां पे ध्यान ये हमें देना है, ये समझना है कि क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 जो है इट इज ऑफ 8 marks. Question number 1 to 4 were of 4 marks each. अगर आपके पास कम समय है तो आपको पहले से ही पेपर देख लेना चाहिए था, या जब देखा तब डिसाइड कर लेना चाहिए था कि क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 जो है उसका वेटेज 8 मार्क्स इस ईच क्वेश्चन है. तो इफ यू फाइंड दैट यू आर रनिंग अ शॉर्ट ऑफ टाइम, 3-4 क्वेश्चन लिखने के बाद, 2 या 3 या क्वेश्चन लिखने के बाद, यू शुड कंप्लीट द क्वेश्चन नंबर 5 फर्स्ट, because it will cover the 8 marks, right? तो इस तरह से कुछ न कुछ आपको strategic formulation भी रखना होगा. Board of director of a progressive limited decide to issue the equity shares of a company with the differential voting right. Examine the provision of a Companies Act 2013. State the condition to be complied with by the company in this regard. 8 marks, यानी आपको condition डिफरेंशियल वोटिंग इक्विटी के लिए जो कंडीशन है वो पूरे के पूरे लिखने होंगे स्टेप बाय स्टेप. 1 साल होना चाहिए, इतना होना चाहिए, डिफॉल्ट नहीं होना चाहिए, पहले इक्विटी होना चाहिए, इतना परसेंट नहीं होना चाहिए, ये रेजोल्यूशन होना चाहिए, इसका परमिशन चाहिए. रिमेंबर इफ यू आर राइटिंग द ईच एंड एवरी पॉइंट यू विल बी एलिजिबल फॉर अ कंप्लीट मार्क. एंड रिमेंबर विथ रिगार्ड टू द डिफरेंशियल वोटिंग राइट द न्यू प्रोविजन, that means the provision of a Companies Act 2013 is applicable. Question number 5B. Again, it is from a deposit. Can you believe it? Deposit is one of the interesting area for any paper setter, because lot of people are not good in understanding the provision of a deposits. Define the term deposit and list out the receipt of a money which are not considered as a deposits, right? Deposit का definition लिखना है और उसके साथ आपको लिखना है list out the money or receipt of the money which are not the deposit. यहाँ पे mark bifurcation ऐसा होना चाहिए कि if you are writing the definition in a correct manner, you will get the 2 marks. And if you are writing the list of the amount not regarded as a deposit, it will be of 6 marks, because a question consists of 8 marks. Most of the students are able to write down the definition, but they are not able to write down the complete list of the receipt which are not regarded as a deposit. वो rules में से है, यानी आपको act और rules दोनों का ज्ञान होना चाहिए. And remember, in a deposit there are so many changes in the last 1 year, right? Therefore, you refer the latest material, do not refer the old material. If you are referring to my book, you refer the paragraph number 1 of chapter number 20, which consists the list of the amounts not included in a deposit. Question number 5 is over. Question number 6, last question of the paper. Question number 6, a practical question. And again, I am very much impressed with the selection of this question, because this question is on the secondary standard 2. और मैंने देखा है कि बहुत सारी reference book में secondary standard का कोई भी reference नहीं है, यानी there is no standard for a secondary standard in a book. Therefore, in my book I have given the separate chapter of a secondary standard, chapter number 35, right? And I have given in a considerable length both the standard. Let me read the question for you. Mrs. Rukmani is an auditor, statutory auditor of Energies Limited. Free reserves of the company are 4 times than the paid up capital of a company. The company has a Rohit, a secretarial auditor. There is a cost auditor, Amit, and the internal auditor, Sunil. Examining the provision of the company is in 2013. Read with the secretarial standards. Now it is specifically provided here. Advise the company as to who is or are required to be present at the forthcoming annual general meeting of the company. Remember, as per the secretarial standard, the statutory auditor, secretarial auditor are required to present at the annual general meeting unless otherwise they are exempted, and they are also having a right to be heard. But they are having a right to be heard only for matters which are related to them. If they are not in a position to attend the meeting, AGM, they may send their authorized representative as per the secretarial standard 2. So this is the answer. It was for a question for 4 marks. Question number 6b. Referring to the provision of a Companies Act 2013 relating to the CSR, answer the following. Which activities would not qualify as a CSR? Pura ka pura list aapko likhna padega. Theoretical question hai. Number 2 usme hi. Whether the average net profit criteria for a CSR is before tax or after tax? This is again the theoretical question, aur mere hisab se question mein hi hint diya hua hai, average net profit. Right. Question number 6C. Now this is a really interesting question from the director or board meeting. 5 board meetings were held in the Asha Limited during the period from January to June in the calendar year 2016. Rajiv, an additional director, attended none of these meetings. For the first 2 meetings, he sought a leave of absence from the board but did not inform the board for the remaining 3 meetings. Examining the provision of a Companies Act 2013, decide whether he is disqualified to act as a director. Remember, section 164 provide about the disqualification of a director, and section 167 suggests that if any director remain absent in a board meeting for a period of 12 months, whether with the leave of absence or without the leave of absence, he will be a disqualified and he is required to vacate the office. But in the given question, the person has remained absent only in 5 meetings which were held during the period from January to June. Remaining positions are not clear, and therefore apparently we can say that the directors are not liable to vacate the office. Question number 6D, last question. Examine the provision of a Companies Act 2013, explain the power of the central government to order amalgamation of a companies in a public interest.
It was for 4 months.
Remember, my dear friend, provision of amalgamation and merger are now applicable from a new companies act. पहले पुराने जो companies act था 1956 का वहां से लागू होता था, but now onwards the provision of amalgamation will be from a companies act 2013, because now the NCLT has been constituted, the provision of NCLT has been made enforceable and applicable. The power of amalgamation, compromise, etc. now vested in the NCLT, and therefore, it is a theory question, therefore the student should write the new provision. In my book, you will find the table number 10, chapter number 27, right? This is all we were supposed to discuss about the paper. Now, for the purpose of better preparation for a June 2017 and the December 2017, you are required to read the Companies Act or a paper of a company law in a very thorough and a digestive manner. Remember, my dear friend, you cannot get or fetch the good marks or extraordinary marks just by reviewing the last few days or just by referring the any category or any quality of a books. Because nowadays in a market you will find a lot of material. Lot of materials are also available on a net free. Lekin ye free material sabse zyada dangerous hota hai. Because you are not in a position to verify ki ye sahi hai, galat hai, updated hai ya kaise lagu karna hai. And remember, do not learn by the chart. Because if you learn by the chart, at that point of a time, jab aap seekh rahe ho, at that point of a time, aapko ek galat ehsaas hota hai ki mujhe sab yaad reh gaya hai. And then in the examination or at the time of testing, you are supposed to write in a para or point to point form. The chart will be the useless and you won't be able to recognize the concept. You won't be able to fetch or get the good marks. So read it thoroughly. Revise it. Do not just read it, revise it also, and if possible make some practice of writing at least 2 papers taki aapko pata chale ki kitne duration mein, kitne samay mein aap apna paper pura kar pate hain. Accordingly you may improve and then you may appear for a final level paper. Thank you very much. All the best.